Well, that's my hot weather ground dwelling setup. Let's have a chat and I'll give you my thoughts. Well, as we're in the middle of a bit of a heat wave here in the UK, which is fairly unusual, I thought it was time to do this setup. It's not one that I get to use that often, really. I could use it more, but I've got a lot of kit and I do like playing with the other stuff, you know. Quite simply, it's an ordinary A-frame shelter, as I'm sure you saw, but hung much higher than normal. I'm about head high with the ridge line, which does mean once I've pinned the corners out with the bungees, I'm, what's this back bit here? Almost probably a meter off the floor. So if we did get a shower, I'm covered. Hot and sunny, I've got shade, but I've got a massive amount of airflow, of course, underneath it, which is what you need, it really is. That's one of the things with tarps or tents, they do trap a lot of heat up in the apex. So having it higher, the heat is away from me, airflow underneath is obviously moving it about as well, which is a help. But it's a handy setup. The other thing I suppose we could say is my sleep system I've got today. Obviously, very hot, don't need much. Just got the jungle bag. But I've got my sleep pad or mat, inflatable, the UL80, because it is the most comfortable that I've got. But it's also probably one of the weakest. So for a bit of protection, I've just zipped him inside the bivvy. Because he's in the bivvy bag, it's another layer between it and the forest floor. So hopefully, no puncture. The other thing, other people probably found this, with some of the sleep mats, the surface can be a bit slippery. And your sleeping bag moves about on it quite a bit. Having the sleeping bag on top of the bivvy bag, it's sort of got a bit more traction. It doesn't move about so much. So that's another reason for doing it, really. But for now, I'm just going to have a drink and take in the scenery.